long hours that were put in. I'm sure each and every one of you felt like you've been through the academy. So congratulations to you as well. While you won't be getting a badge today, you do serve us with honor, because every family member, every friend of one of our first responders, of our firefighters, is a member of our family. So congratulations to you as well. It's an honor to celebrate the achievements of your family members and your friends. You have the members of the graduating class have answered one of the highest callings of public service. Every one of the academy classmates will be charged with protecting the lives of the people of Baltimore. And I know that the training here at the academy is rigorous. I know that it is challenging. So graduation, your accomplishments today are very impressive, and everyone is proud of you. I also want to again acknowledge your friends and family. You've been through a lot. Your love and support is vital. And I hope that you continue to offer your love and your support as they not just finish the graduation ceremony, but as they endeavor to embark upon this new chapter in their lives. We all know the friends and family of current firefighters know what it means to be in life of service. And if you have any question about what it means to be a friend or family member of a first responder, all you need to do is look over here at this I-beam that was delivered 2 weeks ago from the World Trade Center. It is here as a constant reminder of the 343 firefighters that died on September 11th. The brave firefighters ran into burning buildings. They ran upstairs as others were running out to find safety. And we know that if this were to happen in Baltimore, God forbid, our brave firefighters would have done the exact same thing. So every new class coming out of the academy will see this damaged IV as a reminder of the seriousness of their commitment and the brotherhood they share with the thousands of other firefighters throughout the country. Serving in an honorable and noble profession such as fire service comes with an enormous price. Every day you put on your uniform, it symbolizes your commitment and dedication to protect and serve. So on behalf of the people of Baltimore, I want to thank you for your commitment and further pledge my support to each and every one of you. Despite 2 years of budget deficits that exceeded $186 million, we have maintained every single firefighter position and every single EMT position in our budget. And I've worked hard with our state and federal partners secure funding for new equipment as well as new training. And Chief Clark's office is working closely with city staff to develop computer models to better deploy resources throughout the year, ensuring that response times are faster than the national standard. Using sophisticated software, they're able to identify needs faster than ever before. And ultimately, our goal is to ensure that our firefighters, EMTs, and paramedics arrive at the incident as soon as possible. At your station, at the scene of the accident or walking into the community, I want each and every one of the graduates to know that you are an ambassador. People have great expectations of men and women in uniform. Those who came before you raised the bar. And starting today, you will be expected to live up to those standards. I believe you can do it. I know your family and friends here believe you can do it. And they certainly wouldn't be here today if that were not the case. So thank you again for your commitment to our city, to your friends and families. Enjoy this day. Remember this day, because there's going to be a time when you wish they were sitting across from you and they're at work on a long shift. So remember this day, the joy of this day, and the accomplishment that we're celebrating today. Thank you very much. God bless.
You got to do more news out there on the news before the news.